Hi, my name's Elisa. I'm studying vet science in my final year. I love working with people and I love working with animals, and it put those two together for me. I love the challenge of coming every day and seeing something new, and being hands-on with something new every day is really exciting. UQ is definitely a world-renowned university, especially for vet science. And as far as my options for studying vet science in Australia, UQ was nice and close to home and a really well-respected degree. So I was lucky enough to get in, and that was where I ended up. When I first started studying at UQ, I was pretty scared, but also really excited. I just came from Brisbane, so not far away at all. And I remember getting here on my first day and meeting so many people, all interested in the same sorts of things as I was. We have plenty of facilities all geared towards animals. So it's not just about lecture theatres when you're out here. We have places like in here, the hub, where we can get hands-on with all the different skills that we need to practice. We have heaps of animal handling facilities and places we can go to be hands-on with animals as well. We have a lot of really high-tech facilities, like our vet clinical centre here on campus, where students can be hands-on with real clients' animals and learn to be a real vet, which is really exciting. So I guess when we start in first year, there's a lot of time in labs and looking at things under microscopes and things like that. And as we progress through the degree, we get more and more hands-on with animals and treating sick animals as well. There's not really a typical day for me as a vet student. Every day is different, which I think is what keeps things really exciting. But we do plenty of lectures, plenty of hands-on prac work, tutorials, and lots of things after hours for Gatton campus students to be involved in, social events and different special interest group meetings. The biggest challenge for me when I started was really learning how to learn, learning how to commit knowledge to memory and keeping it for each subsequent year, because you're always building on the knowledge that you had from first year. I think that was the biggest challenge as I moved through the degree, was making sure I could learn effectively and retain that information. One of my absolute favourite things I've got to do was treat a cow that had a fracture through the bottom of its jaw, and we treated it by putting kind of like braces on its teeth to stabilise that fracture. And I got to do that and it was successful, and that was probably one of the most rewarding days I've had. We do heaps of placement in our program. So the first kind of 3 years of our degree are really geared towards what we call preclinical placement, which is all on farm. So on a cattle farm, on a horse property, sheep properties. Really learning how those businesses run and work as a business, because if you're going to give advice to farmers, you need to understand that. In the last 2 years, we do a lot of time in vet clinics, hands-on with patients, really trying to figure out what's going on with them while being supervised by a qualified vet, and gearing our skills towards being a real vet. So that's what I've been doing the past couple of years. I was pretty surprised by the community that I met when I came out here in Gatton. I didn't really anticipate to make the number of friends that I did, the number of lifelong friends that I did. I kind of expected uni to be like, you show up and do your classes and you go home and go to sleep. But it's not like that at all. It's about the social life and being part of that community as well, which I didn't expect at all. I'm involved in a lot of the social aspect of living at Gatton. I've lived in the halls of residence my whole time here, so that's our college here at Gatton, and met a lot of my friends through there because you live right next door to them, so pretty easy to make friends like that. But I've also made a lot of friends playing sports and even going to what we call special interest groups, where you get a group of people together who are interested in the same type of vet science. And we can sit and talk about different cases and things that we're interested in. Studying again was one of the best things I probably did for myself and for my studies. Coming out to such a small community, and when I was 17 and I moved out here, I was quite a shy person, very introverted. But the community campus was so small and so tight-knit, and everyone was so welcoming, that was hugely important for me in coming out of my shell and improving myself and my studies. We have extremely supportive staff and support services all across the campus in all our different faculties. So they really make sure that we are comfortable in our studies and progressing well. Some of the non-academic facilities we have at campus include our gym and swimming pool, which is all brand newly refurbished, so beautiful spaces to do our exercise. We have all our halls of residence, which have common rooms and different areas where people can get together and hang out, socialise. I wish that 16-year-old me knew that coming into vet science was not going to be easy. It is academically taxing. I think as a vet, we attract a lot of perfectionists, and just those you want to achieve highly. And you don't always get things perfect and you make mistakes. And I kind of wish I knew that before I had to go on that learning curve and fail sometimes and have to pick yourself back up and try again. Short term, I definitely want to look to work as a GP vet, just in a mixed practice, and pick up some of those skills that you need to start to learn once you've graduated vet science. Long term, I'm definitely interested in working for the government, maybe looking at food quality or export quality. I think a lot of people think that a vet degree means you go and work in a small practice and spay dogs and cats all day, but it's really a lot more open doors than that, I guess. So you can go and work with a whole bunch of different species. You can work with alpacas if you want to. You can go and work in the pharmaceutical industry and develop new drugs that can make a difference for a lot of different animals. You can work for the government, you can be a researcher. You can go and specialise if you're really interested in something in particular. There's just so many different things different pathways you could go down with a vet degree.